I have been in Europe for the last 6 months making a film called What's New Pussycat, starring Peter O'Toole and Peter Sellers and myself, in that order. And it's the first time in my life that I ever acted in anything like that. I have acted before, but I don't count it. Many, many years ago, I was in the nursery school play when I was a child. I played the part of Stanley Kowalski in the school play. We did Streetcar Named Desire, and I was one of the great five-year-old Stanleys. And I wrote the film, and it is an autobiographical movie. It's based on the experiences of a great ladies' man, and I... You're laughing. So it happens, on my honeymoon night, my wife stopped in the middle of everything to give me a standing ovation. Yeah, as a matter of fact, you should know the etymology of how I got to Europe in the first place, which is fascinating. I was appearing in Greenwich Village at a coffee house on Bleecker Street called the Integration Bagel Shop and Free Parlor. I was the master of ceremonies on the bill, you know. And I was on with weird Greenwich Village acts, you know, myself and an Eskimo vocalist who sang night and day 6 months at a time. A little blonde girl who had a child by a future marriage, you know. Adorable. And in walks one night Mr. Feldman, a producer, and he just adored me on sight. He thought I was attractive and sensual and good looking, you know, and just made for motion pictures. He's a little short man with red hair and glasses. And he asked me if I ever wrote anything before. I have been a television writer for years, and I wrote a three-act verse tragedy about a veterinarian faith healer who restores speech to a parrot, you know? And I also wrote a short story about my first year of marriage, which Alfred Hitchcock showed interest in for a while. And he flies me out to Europe, absolutely all expenses paid, TWA flight, you know, movie on the flight and everything. Irene Dunne in The Life of Amelia Earhart, you know, it's a good year. Sitting shaking on the plane, you know. And I meet a girl at my European analyst's. I have to explain this. I was going to a European analyst, and that meant the European boy could see my analyst for 6 months, you know, a neurotic exchange program. I invite her up to my hotel. I get all ready for our dinner date. You know, I anoint myself completely. I beat my body with olive branches. You know, and I throw an amber light on me to make me look really effective. And two little backlights to give me the illusion of three dimensions. And a baby spot to pick out the brown in my eyes. And I put on my mood music records, you know, my Arthur Godfrey Hawaiian music. She had invited me over to her place, but I didn't want to lug the lights and everything, you know, so. And, oh, I didn't dress properly. This was partially my fault. I know how to dress better now, but I was not a good dresser a short while ago. You don't wear argyle with dark blue. I had on dark blue socks and an argyle suit. I look like a farmer, you know. And my radiator breaks, and the hotel room is absolutely freezing. And I'm ashamed, you know, because she's going to come into a cold room. So I go into the bathroom, and I turn on a hot water in the shower, which is an old Brooklyn trick to heat the apartment. And hot water comes down, and billows of steam come into the living room. And ice cold air is seeping in under the windowsill, and the two fronts meet in the living room, and it starts to rain in my hotel room. I'm standing there in the rain, and I did not do well with the girl. Europe, for me, as a matter of fact, was a series of near misses. I was at a cast party with our cast, and I was in the corner, and I was playing the vibes, very sexy, like a jazz musician, really up and down. And a great girl comes up behind me, but really elaborate, and she says to me, "You play vibes?" I say, "Yeah. It helps me sublimate my sexual tensions." She says, "Why don't you let me help you sublimate your sexual tensions?" So I figure, great, you know, here's a girl who plays vibes. turn quickly and ask her out for a date. But Peter O'Toole, who's in the movie, asks her out first. Aces me out, you know. And she was a beautiful girl, so I said to her, could you bring a sister for me? And she did. Sister Maria Teresa. It was a very slow night, you know. We discussed the New Testament, gentlemen. We agreed that he was extremely well-adjusted for an only child.